Hello. In this video, we will solve this problem. Determine I of t. But we will not use differential equation and then transforming into Laplace domain and solving the problem. We will directly write this circuit into S domain and we will directly write the equation there. Okay. So question is determine I of t, that is the current flowing through this inductor. It has two voltage source, one is 50 multiplied by u of t, another one is 50, and we have two resistance 2 and 6 ohm and one inductance 3. So in the last video we have seen that a capacitor in a time domain can be converted into an impedance with 1 by sc in parallel with a current source, its value c of v 0 minus. Or it can be converted into a impedance in series with a voltage source. The voltage source value will be V of 0 minus by S. And similarly, an inductor in time domain can be represented as a impedance in series with a voltage source value minus L of I 0 minus, or an inductance in parallel with I of 0 minus by S. So this is how we can directly write a time domain circuit into S domain. Okay. So before that we need I of 0 minus. So in this circuit at t less than 0, this voltage source will not be active. That means it is 0. It is short. So now we have to calculate. So in the, what is there in the circuit at t equal to 0 minus, this inductance act like a short. So 6 ohm will not come into picture, since there is a, it is in parallel with the short circuit, this 6 ohm will not come into picture. Effectively this circuit will have 50 volt, 2 ohm resistance and 3 Henry inductor. Okay. And we have to calculate I of 0 minus. So I of 0 minus is nothing but you have 50 volt and 2 ohm resistor, so it will be 25 ampere. Okay. Then we will write circuit at t greater than 0. For t greater than 0, we have to write down the circuit. So we can write a single voltage source, we can add, because both voltage source come into picture, 50 and 50 u of t. So that is nothing but 100. So 100, and you have one resistance and one more resistance you have here and inductance. Okay, so that is, what is the value, 2 and 6, 2, 6, 3, 2, 6 and 3 and I of t. We will rewrite this circuit. Since we have one voltage source, two resistance, this part of the circuit we can replace it by a single voltage source in series with the resistance. Using Thevenin theorem we can replace it. Okay. So if you replace that, then the circuit will be one voltage source in series with the resistance and inductance. And this value we have to calculate, this also voltage value we have to calculate. What is the voltage value VTH? VTH is the open circuit voltage across the 6 ohm, that is 100 into 6 divided by 8. So 2 2s are 2 4s are, sorry, 2 3s are 2 4s are, that is 75. So this value is 75 and 2 parallel 6 is the Thevenin's resistance, 12 divided by 8. So this will be 8 ones and 8 5. So 1.5 and 3 I of t. Now this circuit we will transform into S domain. So in the S domain, how to write this one? We have, see, equivalent, how we can transform an inductor into S domain. We have two options. I think for this particular problem, the second one, this option will be useful, because we will get a single loop, and using KVL we can solve. There is no rule that you have to use this equivalent circuit, you can use this also. Okay, so we will take this one, and in that voltage source value will be minus L of I0 minus. So we will rewrite this circuit, that is we have one resistor and this one is the impedance and one voltage source we have to write, and here we have one voltage source. Now yes, remember, now this everything, this circuit analysis we are doing for t greater than 0. So obviously this 75 is multiplied by u of t, we are analyzing for t greater than 0. So in s domain this will be 75 by s. Remember this one, we are always analyzing time greater than 0. So 75 is multiplied by 1 by s, or 75 by s, it's in s domain. Similarly 1.5 is the resistance, it will not change. In s domain also it is same, but inductance, impedance will be sl, s is s domain, and l is 3 s into 3 or 3s, and this value will be minus l I of 0 minus. So that value will be minus, l value is 3, I of 0 minus we calculated it is 25. So totally it is 75, minus 75 you will get. Okay, so yes, this is the circuit. We have to find in this circuit the expression for I of s. We have to find expression for I of s. So what you can write using KVL, from KVL, so we'll apply this one from KVL. So it will be minus 75 by s plus 1.5 into I of s plus 3s I of s, and finally minus L of I of 0 minus equal to 0. So like this I am applying KVL. So then if you group or if you club I of s terms, so this will be, you do this calculation, this will be 3s plus 1.5, and this side, if you take these two, this side, L of this L minus, sorry, L of I of 0 minus is 75, this value is 75, so minus 75 you have to write. This, if you take this side, then 75 plus 75 s divided by s, so this is equal to I of s is equal to, so this will be 25 plus 25 s, just algebraic simplification, you can do it yourself this one. So this will be s plus 0.5. so I have divided 3 denominator and numerator and denominator, okay, that's why you're getting 0 and s plus 0.5, here 25 will get. Now using partial fraction expansion, you solve this one, this will be a by s, or this one you split into 2 first, s into s plus 0.5, and another one 25 divided by s plus 0.5, and this one use partial fraction expansion, so a by s plus b by s plus 0.5 plus 25 divided by s plus 0.5. okay, so a and b you will get 50 and minus 50, so a and b, a is 50 and b is minus 50. Okay, so if you substitute here, I of s is 50, this is 50 by s, and plus both common denominator, b is minus 50, so it will be minus 25, minus 25 divided by s plus 0.5, And if you take inverse Laplace transform this one, so it is 50 u of t minus 25 e power minus 0.5 t u of t. This is the solution.